and David.
Hello, I'm David.
Hello, my name is Dragoș.
We're going to explain you how the website works.
So the website was created using HTML, JavaScript, CSS and PHP.
And on the homepage we have some information about the project and how we want it to do it.
As you can see here, it's a tab. So we have the homepage, as you can see right now. We have the visualization page where you have different visualizations.
And now we have the split screen. For the split screen, we have two visualizations next to each other where we use the iframe. So it still works, but with an iframe.
Here we have the contact page where you can contact us. And here also you have the price where you can just subscribe for a product that you want.
Here we have the team we work with.
And now I leave you with Lucas.
Hi, my name is Lucas.
Hi, my name is Khalid, and we are actually the ones in charge of the node-name visualization in this group. So for this project, we decided to use the D3 library, which is programmed in JavaScript. And the main reason for choosing it was because it has a lot of resources that we can get from the web page.
We made a total of 3 visualizations for the graph. The force directed graph, a radial graph, and a hierarchical graph. We start off with the force directed graph. This is the force directed graph we made. One of the features of the force directed graph is that it can move. It can drag around all the nodes, and when you go over a node, it will expand the node and change the color of all the different nodes. It will also highlight all the edges to which this node is connected. The second visualization we made is a radial graph. This graph is the same as the force directed graph, the only difference is that this graph is based on a circle. Same as the force directed graph, when you go over a node, it shows all the edges to which this node is connected.
For the third one, we decided to make a hierarchical visualization, which also like you can like it's a collapsible one where you can choose every node and then you can like expand it to see like which nodes it contains inside.
Now I leave you with Sana and Yifei.
Hey, my name is Yifei.
My name is Sana.
We were responsible for the adjacency matrix.
So this is our matrix right now. The matrix doesn't work with large data sets, so right now we're using a small subset from the original data set, which is 100 by 100 vertices. On the left-hand side and the top side, it shows the sources and targets. And in the matrix, you can see the cells being colored. And those are the weights of the edges. Every edge has its own color depending on the value. The lowest value is the largest color, but the highest value is the darkest color.
The matrix has a few interactions. When you hover over it with your mouse, the place will turn up green. You can also zoom in and pan it, and furthermore, this button allows you to reorder the matrix.
And now, I leave you with Marco and Tim.
Hi, I'm Tim.
Hi, my name is Marco, and we work together on the data conversion and the matrix reordering for the visualizations. So, if you want the visualizations to work, you will have to upload a .csv file. This .csv file contains a string with all the names separated by one symbol every time. So firstly, there's all the vertices that are put after each other. Then the first vertex is repeated, and that vertex shows all the adjacent vertices to that vertex. And that happens for every vertex. That's how every one of these .csv datasets are built upon, and we can use that to build our algorithms around that and to convert the data sets to something that we can use for example the force directed diagram for which we need a JSON file, as well as the radial diagram. But for the radial diagram, the names are replaced by the indices of the vertices, and also for the hierarchical diagram. Hierarchical diagram requires a whole different data set. It requires a parent, and every vertex needs its parents and its child, its children.
For the adjacency matrix, we have a few reorderings that we made. We have a frequency reordering in which we use a merge sort to
and first organize the rows and then transpose it into the column so that everything is in the right place. And then alphabetical, which is just used with a function in JavaScript. Then the reverse, which is also just a function in JavaScript. The clustering, for clustering we used a library called Clusterfuck. And then for random, like, we use an algorithm in the which we made in JavaScript. In the burning heart, just about to burst, there's a quest for
feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up.